All right, guys, welcome back, and I hope you are enjoying this course. Now that we know a great deal about SQL Developer, a lot of stuff inside the SQL Developer, and we also know how it simplifies our life, let me give you one quick example as to how to run a PLSQL program inside the SQL Developer. Let me close this one. And let us try to run the PLSQL program against the HR schema. And also, guys, remember, any programming language that you're learning, the first program that you write is Hello World. And that's the same thing I'm going to do right now. Understand this, guys, PLSQL is a little bit different than your traditional SQL statements. It is a programming language. That means you need a separate course, separate lesson plan in order to become a PLSQL master. So let me quickly write the simplest PLSQL program, that is begin dbms underscore output dot put underscore line, and then we'll give it as hello world da da da, and then let me close this, and then n, and then slash. Now this is the simplest PLSQL program, guys. Don't stress out. If you are a developer, you might be familiar with these kind of codes. Now, if you are a DBA, you just need to learn PLSQL programming. So we see an error. What's the error? Begin dbms underscore output. Okay, I made the typo error. Output dot put underscore line, and then click on the play button. And can you see PLSQL procedure successfully completed? Now, to see the exact result output, what we need to do is we need to enable this one, set server output on, run this one first. Great. Now what I'll do is I'll try to run this PLSQL block again, and then this time we should get the output called as hello world. Can you see it? So for PLSQL, if they are not outputting your result of the PLSQL block, what you need to do is you need to just enable the set server output on. This will enable the output from the PLSQL block, and then you can see the result on your screen. Even if you are using the SQL Plus, you need to make sure in your session you run this command first, and then you actually execute your PLSQL blocks. Now that's a very simple and the basic PLSQL block. In case if you are interested more to learn PLSQL, I do have plans to publish the course in near future. And if you are part of this course and if you're part of my community, you will definitely get to know about the course when it is published. All right, guys, so that's it for now, and see you in the next lecture.